Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to tell you some easy tips and tricks to by heart Ayurvedic Sanskrit Slokas for BAMS students. The first and foremost thing to follow is understanding, memorizing, implementing or practicing. This method to learn Ayurveda is clearly mentioned in the last chapter of Ashtanga Hridaya itself. That means the author himself suggested the best method to learn his text, so better to follow it. I don't have any idea if there is any defined method to memorize Locus, but I am sharing more here about my personal experience and some of the tips that my gurus told me during my academics which found helpful for me. I also have done little research and gathered some information. If you know any other technique, please mention it in the comment box below so that it will be helpful for other Ayurveda students also. Number 1. Gain basic knowledge of Sanskrit language and start reading original Sanskrit text with available tikas. Write the sloka, understand the meaning of the words by referring the textbook or samhitas. This will help to memorize quickly. Know the correct pronunciation of the words because once it gets by-hearted, it becomes difficult to correct it. So don't by-heart the sloka at the very beginning. First write down the sloka, divide it into words or divide each line into two parts, get meaning of each word, then start reading it. The second point is concentrate only on the important slokas. For the exam purpose, you need not by heart all slokas from all subjects. If you can, then it is well and good. Don't worry much because you will get marks if you write meaning of the words. But to score more marks, you should try using maximum Sanskrit words while explaining the meaning. I mean, if you want a top rank, you need to study as many slokas as you can. For just pass marks, no need to by heart all slokas. Ashtanga Hridaya slokas are really important in first year. If you can by heart maximum slokas of Ashtanga Hridaya, it is well and good. They are going to be useful in your further years because there is no matter which sloka you learnt, you can easily use that sloka in any exam as per requirement. From Sharira Kriya and Rachana, you can select the important slokas and by heart it. The third point is repeating. Repeating often is the only way. Wake up early in the morning, sit in a calm place, select few slokas and read it loudly. Next day morning, recite the old ones first, then take new ones. You can read subject-wise also 5-5 slokas, which is important one. Then continue this process. Practice daily at least 1 hour. Read it loudly so that you can hear your own recitation. This speeds up the memorizing process. Once again, be thorough with the slokas and their meaning because slokas are the best way to remember answers. Repeat the words aloud in musical tune. Thus both verbal memory and musical memory comes into play. If you don't have musical sense, even then also you can follow by reciting each individual lines of the words 5 to 10 times. Then set of 2-2 lines for another 5 to 10 times. Then the whole sloka 5 to 10 times. Any complicated words can be memorized through this method. For example, let us take this sloka. Sharira janam doshanam kramena paramaushadham vastir vireko vamanam tadha tailam ghritam madhu. Assume that there are 4 lines in one sloka. Take each line. From first line, repeat each word 3 or 5 times. Here, first line is Sharira Janam Doshana. Take each word, repeat it 3 times. Sharira Janam, Sharira Janam, Sharira Janam, Doshana, Doshana, Doshana. Then take the whole line and repeat it thrice. Sharira janam doshanam, Sharira janam doshanam, Sharira janam doshanam. Similarly, take the second line kramena paramaushadam. Take each word and repeat it 3 times. Kramena, 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 paramaushadam, paramaushadam, paramaushadam. Then take the whole line and repeat it thrice. Kramena paramaushadham, Krameṇa paramaushadham. Krameṇa paramaushadham. Take the first and second line and repeat it thrice. Sharirajanam doshanam krameṇa paramaushadham. Sharirajanam doshanam krameṇa paramaushadham. Sharirajanam doshanam krameṇa paramaushadham. Then take the third and fourth line and use the same method. Next tip is follow the rhythm. Many slokas follow a pattern in their syllables. Each pattern corresponds to a feel that the poet wants to convey and has a particular rhythm. You can retain them in memory if you follow that rhythm. The fifth point is combine your senses. Use a combination of visual, auditory, kinetic, and tactile techniques when learning something to increase memory 10% compared to learning something with one sense. Visual memory survives longer with age than language-based memory. Next is connecting method and relating stories. You have to imagine some real person, animal or anything and connect it with the other. That is, make one connection story which is easy for you. The more animated and vivid you can make these images, the better. Doing this creates stronger, novel connection in your brain between the word or number and an image. Make it interesting. Make it funny or even weird just in your mind, because these are the things you don't forget easily. Next is revision. It will take it to long-term memory. First way, make a list of verses to be memorized over a month. Keep checking the list. Keep recollecting the verses. The second way is carry small pocket diary with words written or ebook or mobile. Write each sloka on different index cards. Read them over and over. When you get time, try to revise it. My suggestion is to write down the slokas, and it is better than typing it out. This is because you are more likely to remember notes you write by hand than those you type. This is preferable because the physical act of writing stimulates cells at the base of your brain. You already know about RAS. When you are writing by hand, your brain is more active in forming each letter compared to typing on a keyboard. Next is use spaced repetition. Unless we actively work to retain the information that we learned, chances are we will lose it in a matter of days or weeks. So, create your own flashcards, including images, to tie to what you are learning, and it is a powerful learning experience. Memorize with mnemonics. Mnemonics are usually patterns of letters, ideas, or associations such as Vibgior to remember the colors of the rainbow. Acronyms are words formed from the first letters of a list of words. Acrostics are sequence of letters that helps you to remember a list of items. Here, we will use key letters to make a sentence or phrase. Chunking is grouping together so that they can be stored or processed as single concepts. The next point is using cards. Write each locus on different index cards and paste it in your room. Each day, read one of them over and over, or carry it around with you. The 11th point is teaching technique. There is an old saying that the best way to learn something is to teach it to someone else. When I asked, most people mention teaching, explaining, or even just mentioning. If you don't have anyone, imagine your friend or colleague and then teach. Things will become more clear. Next is mirror trick. Repeat the words again and again and practice in front of the mirror. Show confidence on what you say. Use your hands while expressing your words. You can see a paper first when you forget, but you will be able to remember later. The next point is no stress. Create interest. We must have a reason to learn it. Then you can remember it thoroughly. We must be positive about wanting to remember what we are learning. Then we will remember it well. trust your memory. There is no such thing as a bad memory. There are only trained and untrained memories. Too many people don't trust their memory, so they go too slow and obsess over the information, when in reality they could go faster. So trust your memory. The last but not the least is good nutrition and exercise. If you are eating poorly, skipping exercise, not getting sleep, not only your body is going to be sluggish, so is your brain. You must work to keep your brain healthy for it to go fast. Nothing is hard if you learn to enjoy it. Thank you for watching.